The dream is real.
Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, reporting to you live from the safest place on earth, I call it Loveland. I don't know what's going on with Kendra's face, but it's stuck. You ever seen just like you're on the phone, FaceTime with somebody, and the shit don't move, but she really there, so she might be a little off.
Oh my God, I don't want to get some Botox or something.
Put your hands together for the lack of Botox in Kansas City. Her name is Kendra Taylor. I love your face. It looks beautiful. It's just still stuck.
Black don't crack.
Black do not crack. Matter of fact, speaking of black don't crack, you need a red lift in your life. Got those round of applause going. They call him Dr. Sheryl Rae Reid. Hi, sugar.
Hey,
yes, honey. It's the sweetness for me. How y'all doing? How was your weekend?
I was well. I just came back from spring break.
Oh, you was outside?
No, I was just in Salt Lake City. It was not the outside that you would think.
Oh,
it was okay. Very bland, very vanilla.
Okay.
Very vanilla.
Okay. Well, I hope you had a good time. Kendra, I saw you hit a patio, baby.
I did. It was some nice weather, so I went to a patio with a water view. It was nice.
A patio with a water view. Cool. Yeah, you feel good?
I feel great.
What's going on? Your energy's like, I don't know. It's like you're sedated a little bit.
I don't have any energy today.
You're lacking energy. Okay, well, we're going to help you out. And I hope that my Soul Food Sunday gave you some inspiration for your mini me's running around this world. You know what I'm saying? With all that energy, you know what I'm talking about, that you usually have. But just helping them with their life, because I had some real intent with my message this weekend with Soul Food Sunday. I was talking to the dear young queen in episode 75. It's Dear Young Queens. I think we gotta unpack it, y'all. But first, I'm gonna shout out my son, Kenny Burns. Look, this is his design, y'all. This all him. You see the sweatpants? Oh, wait, sweatpants right here. Look at this. He real never socks. Oh, he got socks too. Look, he did it. He did it all by himself, y'all. You see that? You see
the bottom of the foot? Proud.
You see, I'm proud. I'm proud because he talked to the manufacturer, y'all. I ain't had to talk to the manufacturer. I ain't had to talk to nobody. He talked to everybody who's on his head. Text the motherfucker, like, where the shit at? I mean, not where the shit at. But where the clothes? And then motherfucker ain't respond. He hit him with the question mark. Then he ain't respond again. Then he hit him with the exclamation mark. Where my shit at? In emoji. He did that in emoji. Round of applause, Kenny, brother. I love you. I'm proud of you, son. BRNS Lifestyle on Instagram, BRNSLifestyle.com. It's coming this week or next week. So please support him and his brother. His mom and I have been X'd out of the Instagram accounts. We have no control over the business anymore. The dream is real. But ladies and gentlemen, episode 75, Dear Young Queens. I have some amazing queens that join me each and every week. I want to talk about the Dear Young Queens Soul Food Sunday. And I made it an episode because I feel like we have to unpack it, y'all. I'm seeing so many things on the internet that is disturbing me to a discomfort I've never felt. You know, when you look at these TV shows, you know, when you look at these viral videos of these babies fighting, smashing their heads in the concrete. I mean, the lack of compassion. Mm-hmm. I've fought my whole life, but if somebody fell out or somebody got hurt, we stopped. And we were like, what's going on? And I swear to you, I'm talking about as a child, the age of these young ladies that I'm seeing in these fights, like you stopped. The one girl was fighting the one girl over a boy and kept smashing her head into the concrete. It's the most disturbing images I've ever seen in my life. And ladies and gentlemen, these are the infrastructure of our communities. We cannot afford, and I said this in the Soul Food Sunday, we cannot afford for this infrastructure to dismantle in the way that it is, because if they don't care about life, we will have no life. They are the mothers of civilization. And I wanna ask y'all about that, because I don't even think they know their like natural roles in the progression of our culture. Like I don't even think they're getting that they're the maternal, you know what I'm saying, wizardry that keeps us moving forward. Can you talk about that a little bit? Because I'm scared.
I had the same concern. And when I was teaching, I had a conversation with a student. And I said, listen, when you guys go out here and you have these fights, why do you guys jump each other? Like, that was against the rules when we were growing up.
Yes.
You could look at as a punk if you jump somebody. It was always one-on-one. I said, also, do you understand that you can seriously hurt someone? Someone could die.
Right.
Do you know what that student answer was to me?
What?
But they died, they just died.
Yeah, how, Sway?
My expression was like, are you kidding me? Like, really? That's not a part of life. It's like they're desensitized to everything that's evil.
Absolutely.
They're growing up with it.
Dr. Sugar.
Mm-hmm. So, unfortunately, I think a lot of our younger generation have no idea of the finality of the decisions that they make. So,
right.
Suicide rates going up, suicide ideation going up, fights going up.
Wow.
Whenever they hit that black, like they go black, they don't even have any kind of sensor to make them stop. Because once they get to that point, they are going until they either see blood or somebody is hurt.
Right.
It's unfortunate, but it happens so often. And I think it's really linked to the fact that they aren't communicating. So you hold everything in and then you blow all the way up. Like kids that literally, y'all, that don't even have sentences to say.
Right.
They don't say much. They don't say nothing. Then you see them go from mute to fight.
To like, somebody dying. No.
How y'all beefing and we never see you talking to each other?
Yeah, we don't even know.
How does that work?
You don't even know if your words can dissolve the situation because you immediately going from zero to serial killer. And the thing for me is that these parents, and I want to talk to the parents because the one thing I know about children, especially at a young age, if they told no, they looking at you like, right? That means that they're grasping the difference between what just happened and you clearly about to reprimand them in whatever way it is. And I think in that moment, you have a child where you want them because the responsible thing to do is be like, that's not something that you should do. Like touch the stove while the fire is up, or don't touch the iron when it's plugged in. Don't plug anything into a wall without, you know what I'm saying, making sure the devices, whatever the thing is, in that moment, you have an opportunity to teach. Why can't we teach our kids not to be ignorant? Is it because we're so ignorant?
Not teaching them.
No, but is it because we're so ignorant? Because I got to believe, it's not enough to say that people don't have skills, right? Because even when our parents didn't have skills, the teachers, right, were the middle ground, right? I don't care what you say, teachers told you no in a way that made you realize they meant no. They put you in time out, and you go back far enough for people in their 60s, they put hands on you. You know what I'm saying? And you're 40. So my point is, it's like, but we are now scared to discipline these kids. I just was on the Blackout with Earn Your Leisure's Rashad Bilal and the master investor, Mark and Mondays. Big shout out to them and the amazing thing they're doing in the financial literacy world. And they had this topic, and I think it was like 2 days ago that they posted. And all the things they've been posting have been going viral the last 4 days, right? It started with, is Black culture dead? Unbelievable engagement. I've never seen engagement like that. And then the next day they were like, are female rappers, you know, ruining hip hop, right? And the answer is yes, but also the men are ruining hip hop, right? But I want to talk about the female contribution because when you think about the messaging in music, it's not a competitive sport anymore. It's who's going to out-sexualize the other person. It's who is going to say the most outlandish things to get your attention or do the most outlandish things. Sukiyana. This weekend, rolling out, I saw a clip. Disgusting. And I don't believe that the audience really wants to see that. In my opinion, Sexy Red, same stage. And big shout to Rolling Loud. This is not against them. They're hiring who people are paying to see. But at the same time, it was nothing to see. Sexy Red looked like an incomplete puzzle. Dead serious. And everything she raps about means absolutely nothing. Sukiyana the same way. She come out full sucking the mic like it's a dick, you know, tongue out, all the things, right? And this is where we gotta like really call people out. And I got a few more people to call on this episode because it's responsibility. Sexy Red, you just had a baby. You just had a baby. You just had a baby. I don't even know what else to say, but you just had a baby. And you back outside talking about you fucked Aiden Ross because he paid you. Where does this, you ain't hear that, Kendra? Kendra face, look, no. Kendra face it, y'all. We need an episode called Kendra Faces. But baby, she said on the gram, am I lying, Tiffany? She said, the boy said he had sex with Sexy Red. She came like, nah, you, because he was a virgin, allegedly, right? And she said she did have sex with him, but he paid me. I'm like, what? And for people, and yes, Rolling Loud, I'm talking to you in this particular instance. Why are we hiring these people? Why are we hiring these people? Something has to give. Like, this is not even, if you have a daughter, the right thing is to not support anything like that. Am I tripping? Is that not common sense?
I think it is common sense. However, I believe that when people try to start comparing what female rappers were whenever we were coming up, they are trying to compare. They're like, Sexy Red is like this generation's version of Trina. And Cap. I was like, that's apples and oranges.
Yeah.
It's not the same.
But it also was a nuance then, no sugar. It wasn't the, and listen, freedom of expression, nuances were amazing back in the day, but they were amazing because they weren't the norm. So if there's a norm now that completely dumbs down a race of people, because it's black women that's being degraded. Margot Robbie ain't posting, dancing to that shit. All the things that they do, even if they listening to it at the house, but you don't see them on Instagram going viral for supporting that bullshit. So what does that do for a race of women, Kendra? Like, this is black, the woman, black human race is not just marginalized, not just the most disrespected human on the planet, but now the most disgusting. Is that how we want to be looked at? Or y'all want to be looked at?
No. It's a huge misrepresentation as women, as black women. Growing up, yes, we did have some rappers like Lil' Kim.
Yeah, definitely ratchet.
But we also had representation of, we had TV shows that was catered to families. We had
Facts.
The Huxtables. So you had doctors and lawyers that were raising children, and you had something to look forward to, like, oh, this is kind of the family I will have.
Right.
And then the spinoff was A Different World, those kids going to college. So that was something to look up to.
Right.
So, and then like Family Matters. Now we don't have those kind of shows.
Right.
To show you the normalization of a family and what family look like, because we did, some of us did come up in broken homes.
Right.
Now we have reality shows where you have successful women on the show throwing food, throwing water, throwing drinks, and acting a complete fool. So what does that give our kids to look at, especially the kids that are not being parented at home?
Man, listen, you hit a nail in the coffin with the shows. This is to all of you who have shows that make women fight. You are part of the problem. And the networks that support this are part of the problem. This is not an example of who we are. That's just like Donald Dump. He is out here talking about bloodbath, y'all. This man said there's going to be a bloodbath. Who doesn't go to jail for saying that after inciting January 6th insurrection? But I'm telling you, these women, they're being groomed to be self-destructive. They're being groomed by society saying you are successful if you do this. There's nothing beneficial about that. And it goes back to your comments about Lil' Kim and them. Yes, but they also wrap their face off. So for every risque outfit, for every moment they had a, I'm a real rapping motherfucker though, and I make great songs and music. Listen, if we want to go back, we could tear the whole shit down, even back to Miles Davis. He talked on record about putting hands on women. You know what I'm talking about? Like, you had Ike Turner. That man said, I slap up a couple times. And that's the thing I want to talk about to y'all. Y'all want change, but y'all don't want to change nothing. Y'all want change, but you don't want to change nothing. They posted this thing and everybody's comment on the blackout thing with Ian Dunlap and Rashad Bala, they were talking about how, because they asked the question, is black culture dead? Well, wouldn't you think something was dead if you didn't own it? First and foremost, let's just start with that. If you don't own something, is it black culture? Is it yours? Is it an art form that you own? So I just think that we get up in this debate of nonsense, right? This ongoing, I could say something just because I have Twitter fingers, or I could post in the comments, and you're really not making sense. What is ours? Our culture is not black women being misogynistic and using sex as a weapon. That's not our culture. But if you think hip hop is not our culture, you're sadly mistaken. If you look at hip hop and what it's done for dialect, the way we talk, the way we walk, the way we write, the way we show up in culture, all that's the way we eat, what we eat. We done redesigned life. We done made veganism cool. That's hip hop. Like, I'm just saying, like, all types of things, that's culture. People talking about hip hop ain't culture. We got too much ancestor. Okay, no one's talking about that. We're talking about culture today. Culture in the 70s had an identity that was unmistakable. It was civil rights. It was freedom. It was jobs, equality, all the things. Our generation, we made the money. We made the money. We got access to everything. But we still blaming everyone for our actions. That's why I'm saying ain't nobody, they talking about these plants, right? I get it, plants. But no, you gotta wanna do this shit. And then we have to support it for it to be cool. Ladies and gentlemen, we make everything cool. We say go. How y'all feel about that? Because I believe we're on a hamster wheel trying to decide who's at fault and not blaming ourselves.
We gotta take accountability. That's the real issue here. And that's the issue with a lot of things. Whatever thing you look at, it's about accountability. Whether it's the music that is being put out, whether it's what we consume, whether it's what we eat, whether it's the relationships that we're in, whether it's how we interact with people, whether it's how we come outside dressed inappropriately for outside. Like, it's all of the things. It's about accountability. And unfortunately, people hide behind, this is a free country, I can do what I want to do. Quit using that as your excuse to
no, you can't.
Like you don't care about yourself.
Facts. No, you can't.
Stop doing that. And then whenever Kendra just talked about how we had some balance, we had some, you know, risque musicians and rappers that were saying whatever they wanted to say, but lyrically sound. And then we had a good representation, a different representation of positive black women in as lawyers, as doctors, as whatever.
Yeah.
But there was balance. Now, right now, y'all, there is literally the lack of balance.
Fact.
So when you come into a situation and you interact with these young girls and you are not what they see, they don't know how to interact with you.
Nah,
so you just
sure.
have to sit them down and have that talk with them, because they don't have the parents that are interacting with them in the same way for the most part. And then whenever you try to talk to them, they don't know how to receive it because they're used to being talked at instead of talked to.
Wow. Absolute facts. And the thing about that too is that, you know, when you look at like, you know, like the Zeus Network, right? I mean, it was created on the dismantling of black culture. And that's facts. They don't have nothing. I mean, look at Nick Cannon's new show. Nick Cannon, brother, I know your heart. And I know you got all them baby mamas for some ego kind of self-worth thing. Or maybe it's because you want to leave this legacy. And if you're going to take care of them, fine. That's your business. Let's not even judge you for that. But you, Mr. Happy-Go-Lucky, Will Smith-esque potential, you gonna do a show that degrades black women when you got all them baby mamas? You are an oxymoron. You are a contradictory. And I have no respect for you. And you know I know you. And I'm not letting this shit go no more, because we have a lot to unpack. And that's why I was saying to you, Kendra, we gotta think about all the music. All the music we ever motherfucking heard. The reason I went on a rampage with music the last episode and tried to remind y'all of the feeling, because it was words that meant something and it fucking affected you in a certain way. You don't think these words are affecting us? You don't think it's affecting our babies to do all the wrong shit? To think that all that shit to Sugar Point is cool? That ain't cool. Because guess what generation is not doing that? The other, let's say everything but black. Guess what cultures have more couth and have more resolve and more commitment to legacy and heritage than us? And then you tripping when somebody questions, do you believe black culture is dying? Y'all gotta stop living in Africa when y'all ain't never been, first and foremost. I'm tired. I'm tired. This your home. Generations of your family come from here, and we can be respectful to our heritage, find out what that is, go to the tribe. I love the opportunity. But you are from here. You are from America. Your ancestors died, bled, and built this bitch. And you want to talk about, but you don't understand, because you don't understand shit either, nigga. If I don't understand, you don't either. Then you acting like a nigga, as conscious as you are, nigga. I'm tired. Y'all really be out here fucking up the algorithm. You, we, us, it don't be they. We gave them hip hop on a silver platter. I said it on the blackout again. Big shout out to Rashad and Ian. In 1996, after the beef of all beefs in music, we forgot about ownership. Oh, it became about materialism only. It became about having. And we was willing to keep doing these fucked up deals to have money that we thought was money. Not looking at what we just built now.
Message.
Because if you looked at the charts, in the 90s, we ran the world. We made hip hop the biggest form of music in the world. Hip hop went into R&B. Hip hop went into fashion. Hip hop went into every genre of business, but we ain't own shit. And the problem is us. The mothers of civilization are under attack. What you gonna do? What you gonna do? The civilization we known to be the protectors of the black men who fuck up constantly. We're the backbone for that. It wasn't brothers helping brothers. Fight the power, we got all we got. You niggas wasn't on that shit. It was the black women. How do y'all feel about that? Because I think women just don't care like they used to care. And it's a problem. And they have every reason to feel that way, by the way. You know, in today's world, it seems the best treatment is reserved for only a few. Well, Discover wants to change that by making everyone feel special. That's why with your Discover card, you have access to 24/7 live customer service, as well as $0 fraud liability, which means you're never held responsible for unauthorized purchases. Finally, no matter who you are or where you are in life, you feel special with Discover. Learn more at discover.com/creditcard. Limitations apply. TKBS Nation, for decades across various episodes and genres, McDonald's has shown up in the anime world, most commonly called WicDonald's. For the month of March, McDonald's will be bringing the WicDonald's world to life with episodic shorts and manga comics. To celebrate everyone's love of anime, McDonald's is celebrating the love from the culture by launching the limited edition WicDonald's experience, complete with the limited release of their savory chili WicDonald's sauce. For a limited time, anime fans will have the opportunity to experience their favorite fictional restaurant and taste the bold new chili sauce with your 10-piece nugget. I know I love a 10-piece meal complete with some fries and a chocolate vanilla shake. The bold new flavor is available for a limited time until March 25th. So be sure to check them out at your local McDonald's today.
And we're back on Dealing Together, where we help good people who fell for bad deals. First caller?
I had to buy 3 identical sweaters to get the 4th free.
Ooh, you got fleeced. Next caller, what's your deal?
I paid for 20 tanning sessions, but had to use them in a month. Now I'm orange.
Ooh, you got burned. Next caller.
I traded in my old Samsung at AT&T for a new Samsung Galaxy S24 Plus.
How's that bad?
I got to choose from their best plans.
So, what went wrong?
Oh, nothing went wrong.
And you're calling to...
to request a song?
You want a song. Of course.
The choice is yours.
Our best smartphone deals. Your choice of plan. Learn how to get the new Samsung Galaxy S24 Plus with Galaxy AI on us with eligible trade-in. AT&T. Connecting changes everything.
Offers vary by device, subject to change. S24 plus 256GB offer available for a limited time. Terms and restrictions apply. See att.com/Samsung for details.
TKBS Nation. Toyota is doing big things helping grassroots community organizations across the country with its Nudge campaign. The Nudge campaign reflects Toyota's commitment to supporting and furthering the success of those who need it most. A few months ago, Toyota debuted the After the Nudge podcast. The podcast is a 7-episode limited series hosted by acclaimed journalist Soledad O'Brien and former NBA All-Star J.R. Smith. It features conversations with community organizations that Toyota nudged via $10,000
microgrants. We get to find out what happens after the nudge. On the After the Nudge podcast, you'll hear from founders and leaders like Palana Lamagne from Black People Will Swim, Dr. Khalid El Hakim from the Black History 101 Mobile Museum, Demetrius Harris from Fly Compton Foundation, and others. Learn how a simple nudge from Toyota helped boost their momentum, amplify their movements, and or propel them to greater heights. Look for the Toyota After the Nudge podcast on Toyota.com or wherever you listen to podcasts. This episode of The Kenny Burns Show is brought to you by Mickey D's. The realest conversations always happen in the Mickey D's booth. Oh, baby, I want extra pickles. Yeah, that's right, extra pickles. And then give me a chocolate milkshake and add some vanilla and strawberry. All the best nights out in with a bite from Mickey D's. Jessica, I can't feel my face. Please, let's go by McDonald's. A full car ordering in the Mickey D's drive-thru is just the right amount of chaos. Excuse me, I said I wanted the quarter pound of cheese.
You said filet of fish.
I'm telling you right now what I want. A full car of
what you want
in the Mickey D's drive-thru is just the right amount of chaos.
What you want, Kenny?
I want a Big Mac meal, 10-piece nuggets, and 2 milkshakes.
He wants a big
and a filet of fish.
Boy, what you want?
Mickey D's is the affordable answer to taking the whole family to dinner. Everyone's got their own Mickey D's moments. Go on and make more delicious memories today.
I just really want us as a culture to stop selling ourselves.
Facts. Hold on. My little mute came with a bar. You motherfuckers better start busting that gun from Kansas City.
Because that's the problem. Like, whenever a bag is going to make you do whatever, that's when you're selling your soul. Like, and that's what's wrong with our culture. Aren't you guys tired of being sold? We were sold as slaves.
Come on.
Our ancestors were sold as slaves.
Come on.
Now you guys have been selling yourself over these past years.
Come
and
on.
You continuously do it. And that's why we're in the situation we're in today. It's because of that. We are too smart, too conscious to go for the bullshit, but they keep going for it because you can go to certain people that never had anything that would do anything to be able to go and buy a Louis Vuitton purse or something like
right.
that. I'm scared of people like that.
Yeah.
If you will do any, if money is the most important thing to you in life, I'm scared of you.
Yeah.
Because that means you'll do anything to get ahead. And I don't want to have nothing to do with you
at all. Absolutely. That's why I kept saying our black queens are bigger than a Birkin. You making decisions on what you could have. You know what I'm saying? Out of the situation. You're not even going into it being thoughtful about a relationship. You're not even going into it thinking about, you know what I'm saying, like long-term anything. You want to get something immediately, and it's a Birkin that could get stolen tomorrow. Your house could burn up. This shit going to go, then what? And you know what else is disturbing? You know, Kendra, and great, great fucking, I'm just so glad you woke up. But the point I'm trying to make, y'all, is that we literally are selling ourselves at every turn. You're not even comfortable with the small wins. Do you realize these children are not happy without the big win? That is a problem. If you can't go outside and skip a rock on some water, y'all remember we used to do that shit, and that not just blow your motherfucking mind how far that rock is kicked, you got issues. Because guess what? They're waking up, compete, and compare. Because the motherfucker Aiden Ross just bought some pussy and he bought his friend a Lamborghini and gave him a fucking Richard Mille. It's different times, and I get the pressure. But the point is, but the small things, y'all. My son, I tell him all the time, he had one of the best high school careers, way better than mine. But it wasn't enough because it wasn't, you know, Ant-Man is his best friend. He got $300 million for a thing, but that's Ant-Man's journey. Y'all gotta be okay with what y'all got. And ladies and gentlemen, freedom to move is the most important thing in the world. And freedom to move doesn't take all the money in the world. It takes, okay, what makes me truly happy? What brings me joy? I just got new windows. I could have bought the Porsche Targa. I want it, but I had to get new windows because the fucking light hits different now in the fucking studio. You understand me? But what's important to you? We don't know what's important. I said on the blackout again, when last time you been to a family reunion? When last time you actually listened to the words come out of my mind? When last time you was forced to go over your auntie's house? When the last time you had engagement that was worth something? That's to me, y'all. Listen, you talk about being in the right rooms. Start with your family. Start with the media you see around you now. Y'all talking about these rooms. These people ain't shit. You go show up green if you want to.
Go on, show up and not listen to the Kenny Burns Show and get this free game. Go on, show up to a motherfucker that don't care but nothing about you. I want to go on something that I'm not going to share, but I just was about to. But they don't give a fuck about you. They will get rid of you in a snap of the fucking fingers if it benefits them. So y'all better define what's important. Because we at a precipice. You like that? Came back with the precipice. It's been about 20 episodes, but I did. But I want to talk about this too, because I feel, and I want to know y'all opinion. You know, I don't think society will ever be the same again. And I say that because there's been too much psychological damage, right? But the fact that AI can replace your voice, the fact that AI can replace your face. You know, it's coming where you could show up and you not be there. Not literally physically, but in any medium that we use on social and digital. How do y'all feel about that? Because I don't even know how important real is anymore.
Real is important because, let me tell you, real is important to those of us who really care about who we are as a person and as people all the way at our core. Mm-hmm. Those people who don't care or don't want to know who they are at their core, they won't do the work. They don't care about real, they care about appearance. Mm. So appearance and reality are not necessarily two things that coexist.
You smart.
Unfortunately, we are in a world where what you see is not necessarily what you get.
Facts.
Because
all the
like
time.
When you were just talking about AI being able to replace us or facial recognition and all of those things, you don't know whether you see in Sheryl Rae Reid or not.
Facts. You don't. You don't.
Mm-hmm. But the thing is, whenever you get in that spin cycle of, you know, it doesn't matter because I can recreate it with this and that, you are really losing yourself.
Man, but Sugar, it's like we know we being taken advantage of and we still don't do nothing. It's like you know the problems. You know you ain't cleaned your fucking yard up. When we were doing the Amazon, big shout out to Amazon, we were refreshing these neighborhoods, right? I'm talking about the smallest amount of money, y'all. I'm talking about money you can go borrow. You can go panhandle to get. People were letting time lapse on their property and about to get their shit taken because we know better. We know we not supposed to be doing certain shit. We know the effects that alcohol and drugs has on our community. We know our own limits, but yet we test the limit. You know damn well more than two drinks, you're gonna need a whole team to keep you in place, right? But you get that third and fourth drink. And then you act out and you wonder why you lost your job. You wonder why you in jail. You wonder why something happened you can't control. Listen, y'all, it's getting to the point where I say it all the time. We becoming the robots. We do exactly what they want us to do. It don't even take much no more. And then you had actual black and brown people talking about a stimulus check. There wasn't no money. Like, have you thought about that, y'all? That stimulus wasn't no money. Only motherfuckers that won was the people who got over on the PPP. I'm talking about the big money, the hundreds, thousands, millions. And didn't have no motherfucking business, but started one. And God bless you. Be on your way. It's the American way. Get it? Listen, figure it the fuck out. But at the same time, the people who really talking about, oh yeah, he such Donald did, well, he ain't do shit. And it's your money. And it's your money. You pay taxes, that's your money. They just giving you Social Security early. They giving piece of what you're gonna get anyway, which you might not get to all you 40 and 50 year old motherfuckers, which you might not get. So listen, let me tell you one thing about life. We gotta make some changes today, y'all. We have to decide today, and I know we've been doing the work on TKBS. All of us have been better from these conversations. But what are we doing actively? Come on, y'all. Talk about what we could do actively, Sugar and Kendra. We need action. And I got some actionary items, but I want to hear what y'all think.
One thing we really honestly need to do, and I talked about it earlier, was be accountable. And if you're around people that don't hold you accountable, then you need to separate yourself from the people that just
Facts.
Allow you to just keep doing silly stuff. Like,
Facts.
If I am so blessed to have such good friends around me. They check me, they check on me, and they will check somebody about me.
Hello?
Because my thing is, I'm not always right.
Yeah.
It don't matter how many degrees you got.
Come on.
It don't matter how much common sense you got. It don't matter how much street cred you got. You're not always right.
Yeah.
And you got to have somebody around you that's going to check you when you are not right, or check on you when you are going through something.
Mm-hmm.
Because we all have highs and lows, and I don't think that a lot of people want to deal with the lows. Like, baby, you do the work, deal with what you got to deal with so that you can come up and show somebody else, okay, you know what? I have dealt with this. I have dealt with that. Let me see what I can do to help you.
And I'm coming to you, Kendra. But I want to say, if you're waking up every day competing and comparing, where is any normalcy in your life? Where's any balance in your life? Kendra and Coco were talking, Sugar were talking about, child, she got 27 names in my head when I talk about it. I think about what's going on. But like, you literally, you don't have any balance. We all agree that balance is the most important thing in life. In life. If you're going through this world without balance, you're gonna be walking sideways your whole life, living sideways. This is not even up for debate. You think you're in control and you're not. And you need to take control. But Kendra, you about to say, baby?
I would really like for these executive producers or whoever's producing some of these shows on these networks, reality shows, to change the narrative. Like, they feel like that the chaos on the shows is what bring views. Mm. We need some representation of some positivity
facts
as well. Because that, we want to see that as well. I want to see women that are handling business, that can know how to communicate amongst each other, that knows how to support one another, that knows how to not just be in a world of chaos for views. Let's change the algorithm
right
on these platforms as well. Stop clicking on these viral videos that's dumb as hell, and all you're doing is just transferring it to our kids. And
that's
things
it
like that. And so the people that don't have the mindset to differentiate between real reality
and
falsehood, they're taking that into consideration and thinking
facts
that that's real and that's what needs to be done. And that is not true. We need mm-hmm to change as a people on, like we've said many times before, what we intake and also what we support.
And I agree, Kendra. And I want to challenge all of the news sites, Baller Alert, which they really don't do it, but the Shade Room, the Jasmine Brand, all of the news sites that we depend on daily. Let's stop posting the ignorance. We don't gotta post babies fighting. We don't. We don't have to post that. That's not something we have to post. And I guarantee you, that shit probably slow down or damn near stop if they know they're not getting attention from it. So let's stop the whole World Star, and I blame you, World Star, you started that shit. But let's stop that, right? Let's stop promoting it. Let's stop giving it a platform. But then too, we gotta think about, like, you know, how we wanna show up as a people now. We really have to think about that. And you gotta stop being scared to say something. I'm in the Tesla Charger yesterday, going to give me some Garrett's popcorn, child. I had a fix, child. I don't know what was wrong with me. I needed that specifically, and Tiffany ain't had my back. But I wanna say this though. I'm in the thing, and the babies, first of all, people on their charge station, and it's two guys, two girls, and they walking, but they walking a little too close to people getting in their car. You know what I'm saying? And my thing is, like, one of them's being just extra for no reason. Before I could say something to him, the guy came out of his car looking like he had something because the dude was like walking close to an open door. But I'm looking at the baby like, what the fuck are you thinking? What are you thinking? People will shoot you in the face for no reason. And it can't be just the parents, y'all. This is a PSA. It can't just be the parents. You people out here seeing shit, you gotta say shit. You gotta save somebody from themselves sometime. I'm telling you, I done it 15, 11 times. I'm sure as a teacher, y'all have done it too. But it's like, you see something, say something. If you notice something, you got an opportunity. I'm always saying protect yourself and be safe. But dog, ain't nobody just going crazy on nobody in a public place. That's not the majority of people's actions. The majority of people's actions in the public place is, if they do dumb out, they're gonna get inferior because so many eyeballs about to be on them, phones about to come out, police 9 times out of 10, 10 steps away at a gathering. I'm just saying, why not say something? Why not stop some bullshit from happening? The shit that happened in Kansas City, Kendra, I'm sure that was of all the motherfuckers there, I'm sure that was dissolvable. But it was to Sugar's point. Motherfuckers don't even know how to communicate. Well, guess what? Some people do and they need to step in. I know calm heads have saved more crimes from happening and more violence from happening than nothing being said at all. I can guarantee you that.
It's just wild out here because it's like, as much as I don't want to harp on the fact that these kids are not being parented, unfortunately, it seems like their parents weren't parented. Because facts. The ignorance that they give to their children, which normalizes their ignorant behavior, it's like you can't even really talk to them. I was downtown over the weekend.
Right.
I had a little staycation and the SEC tournament was here. So Nashville is always a lot of people.
Right.
I mean, it's always a lot of people, but it was just
a lot
of people. So I'm getting something to eat. And it's one of those areas where you could get whatever you want. It's a bunch of different places downtown. So these girls, they couldn't have been in high school. They definitely were in middle school. Were going up to all the soda fountains, getting stuff, pouring it back in there. And then one of them said, "What the F?" I said,
right.
And she just looked at me and I said, "Sweet love, you don't have to use those words."
Hello.
And you could tell that they were unaccompanied. They were not with anybody.
Yeah.
They're just doing whatever they want to because their parents just let them go downtown.
Yeah.
Or they don't even know they're down there.
Yeah.
So then you down there acting like you don't have any sense because your parents, unfortunately, aren't able to teach you that because they ain't got none.
Right.
So now you're manipulating people to make them think that you need something when you should just take your butt home.
Listen.
But I couldn't say any of that to her. I just had to say, "Baby, you don't have to do that."
Yeah. We you said this earlier, Kendra. We need more programming that fits the criteria of success for the black and brown communities. Even T.I. and Tiny's family show. I love that motherfucker when it was on. I was just like, it's so good to see somebody in that industry committed to his wife and the kids actually being kids. You know what I'm saying? And I need more acting than I do need reality, to be honest. In my mind, I think we need more shows about that kind of lifestyle. I think we need HBCU oriented shows. We need things that are going to fortify us as human beings, y'all, because guess what? The content ain't going away, but the human interaction and importance in everyday life is going away. It's going away. Y'all kids don't want to go to school no more. And I get it. It's not as interesting. I didn't want to go to school, but there's a process to life that has everything not to do with social and digital. You know what I'm saying? You think that these video games, you think that this internet is going to, like when I tell y'all, and I would love to do a study. I would love for somebody to do a study, and Tiffany has been done. We need to share it with the nation, but I would love to do a study on how many people think they're just going to be an overnight success. You know what I'm saying? I would love to see the results from that because I would guarantee you it's in the fucking 90 percentile. Because they don't want the education, y'all. They don't even want to.
They don't do nothing.
Child, help me. Please help me.
Even content creators, I just wanted to piggyback off of that because let me tell y'all something. I was on spring break, right? I am currently a teacher. So I was on spring break and I was like so committed to making sure I recorded content in order to do reels for my spring break.
Mm-hmm.
When I tell y'all how I did not finish posting my stuff about spring break because right. It is so intense.
Right.
I don't understand why people think that being an overnight success means easy, because it does not. Being a content creator means you ain't got to do too much. Absolutely not.
Yeah.
I'm like, I just don't know how much of this I can do. I'm over it.
Yeah.
I am over it because it takes a lot of time
to
put into it. So as much as you don't want to go to school, don't want to finish your degree, you think you can just do this and that, you're going to be working 10 times harder than somebody else that may have a little bit more education, formal education, let me use that term, than you do, because you have to put in more work because you're working an hourly job.
And Tiffany Hamilton Burns and found the statistics we was looking for on that study I said I wish was out there.
Based on a survey that was done by The Sun in the UK in 2017, out of 3,000 children and their parents that were tested, they said over 3/4 of the young people were considering careers in online videos at the time over traditional careers. That was in 2017. So if we're talking about 3/4, out of 3,000 kids, that's at least over 2,000 children out of the 3,000 that were wanting to opt in at that time to be internet famous. Me having grandkids that are 8 and 7, my 8-year-old granddaughter asked me to make YouTube and TikTok videos all the time because she wants to be famous. So I do believe that we are in the 90th percentile, but it's because it's our fault. Because
why your face ain't in the camera though?
Oh, my fault. It's our fault because of the emphasis of trying to make it, like we were talking about the Clone Tyrone episode, when KB pointed out about the fact of everyone was sold on treating, you know, fame like the lotto. The problem is that now there's no emphasis because everybody wants that meal ticket to just get out instead of, you know, going the route that KB's been promoting with the show.
Okay, Tiffany, thank you. Round of applause for Tiffany Hamilton Burns. Oh, she done pushed the whole thing back. All right, well, listen, I want to wrap up the show by saying this, y'all. Thank you, Tiffany. Jay-Z said it best on the stage at the Grammys. Some of us just ain't made to be what you think you made to be, y'all. He said in that particular case that evening that, you know, some of y'all don't deserve to be nominated, you know, and you don't. You know, you have to be worthy in this lifetime. Worth is defined by what you bring to the table. And we're not bringing that to the table, y'all. We just not. Culturally, we are fucking corrupted. You know, culturally, we are mentally bankrupt. Culturally, we are just in a spin cycle that continuously shows that we're not worthy. It's not a thing of like what you can be and can do. We've shown for generations that we are the strongest, most formidable people. We've shown that generation after generation with all the shit they done to us. In the last 50 years, we can't blame it on they. We've had access and more money than we've had in any generation before us. The fucking crazy shit is this generation has even more. But yet we are destroying our art form. Hip hop is our culture. I don't want to hear nothing else about it. Go argue with your mama and whoever else wants to listen to that dumbass shit. But we are giving everything we built away. So what you about to build now? That's my question to the young world. Hey, young world, what you about to build now? If you're gonna tear down everything that was provided to you, what you gonna build now? I'm curious and I really want to know. Before we leave, Sugar and Kendra, just share a little bit with the nation as we get up out of here, because you are queens.
I would like for our young queens to change their mindset and change the intake of what you're watching and what you're thinking that the world is today.
Yeah.
Let's read more, let's research more, and let's do what we want to do, what we want to be. Let's be better than the things that we're seeing on the internet. Yeah, you can be free, you can express yourself, but be a lady about it. Have a little grace with it. That's more attractive than anything that you're seeing on the internet. I didn't see the video of
Rolling Loud
concert where Sukiyana came out, but that is not tasteful.
Oh, disgusting. Disgusting.
And at one point in time, she was saying that she was trying to change her brand. I guarantee you that she felt like she was going to get more money being what she had been than what she really wants to be.
Come on.
Some of these young women don't want to do that. They're doing it because they've been sold themselves with the image, and they have people behind them that keep selling the image that they want them to sell to destruct your mindset of where you need to be. That's as a young woman. So please, gather yourself and find someone that you can look up to that has something like in personality or something like that that you would love to be or admire. And go that route.
Yeah.
Because Sukiyana and Sexy Red, that ain't it, baby.
That ain't it. And they probably got STDs. A lot of them. Sorry. Dr. Sugar.
If you don't have a tribe, find your tribe.
Hello.
If your tribe is only celebrity status people that have doctored up themselves in order to be somebody that they didn't come into this world as, you need to reevaluate what your thoughts are as far as what's normal and what isn't. hold yourself to your own standard of success. I've said that a million times.
Yeah.
I have said that a million times. You really got to readjust. Stop thinking about what everybody else has to say if it's not affecting your livelihood.
Come on.
Who cares? It doesn't matter. Everybody has a right to have an opinion. That has nothing to do with you. What you think about me has nothing to do with me.
Come on.
Just because somebody doesn't like you, and I have graduated from this, thank God. Just because somebody doesn't like you, that does not necessarily mean that you've done anything wrong or done anything to offend them. A friend of mine literally just posted the other day, sometimes Black women are held to the standard where people are intimidated by us. And it's not always because we are more outspoken or whatever. It's just because we are who we are.
Yeah. Facts.
So don't bow down because somebody is intimidated by you.
Yeah.
Stand on what they say, stand on business.
Stand on business. Amen.
Stand on business respectfully. There's a way.
There's a way. And I love how you ended that respectfully. Because you ignorant motherfuckers out here don't even know how to communicate. And we need better from you. And dear young queens, before we leave, I just want to tell you that we will not be all right if you are not all right. And I need you to do the work, you know, get the therapy, find the tribe, get the things that's going to uplift you in a way that you can sustain. Because to Kendra's point, you're going to be on drugs trying to keep up some shit that you can't stomach yourself.
Amen.
You're going to be on some type of, have some type of addiction if you don't fix that. And that's not life.
Amen. Amen.
All right, we're going to get up out of here. Episode 75. Dear young queens, please share it with the nation. Kendra, it's on you.
1, 2, 3.
The dream is real. The dream is real.